Hello again! Today, I want to show you... not much, I guess. Let's change that, shall we? Press this button, and maybe enter something. Hello... You... To... How are you and now we can see a nice little text here typed in using a command block typewriter inside Minecraft. Possible thanks to a small addition in the latest snapshot. A small addition, but it makes so many things possible. So let's have a closer look at what happens here. In 14W20 we got the addition of selectors inside terror commands, which means we can now target individual players and print out their names, which might be used for maybe high scores or different messages specific for different players. Things that weren't possible with just a say command or the scoreboard display before. But there's more you can do. Let's look at this. Two identical command blocks with identical commands. If I activate this one, you see I am text, but this one will give out I'm not. The difference here is not in the command, as said. Identical commands, which target the nearest non-player entity. And if we look down here, we have one squid called I am text, and one squid I'm not. So this command block will output the name of that squid down here, I'm not. And this command block will output the name of I am text. And the best part is, we're not limited to one selector per terror, we can combine several. So for example, now I can combine the selector for the nearest player and for the nearest non-player and give out a text like this. This means that instead of creating one command block for each single output we're to make in the chat, we can use just a few command blocks in which we combine different named entities to create unique text. We can dynamically generate strings in Minecraft now. Awesome feature, and I just brought this to the extreme by, instead of just combining different words, combining single characters. Alright, here it is. At first you will notice the chickens. We have 5 chambers, each filled with 50 chickens. Each chamber represents one line of text I can edit, and each chicken is one position in each of those lines. So yes, I am fairly limited, 5 lines with 50 character maximum in each. But let's have first a quick rundown of the different parts of the system. On the top here we have the setup that displays the complete text. And if I hover over the parts here with my mouse, you can see the different entity UUIDs for each entity for each different position, each one representing one character in the text. Then down here I have the layout for the keyboard. The keyboard keys are nothing more than click event terror commands, each one placing a redstone block in different parts of the system. Maybe interesting to notice, the switch from upper to lowercase and vice versa happens by activating the part back here that switches out these 2 row of command blocks to switch between the 2 key layouts. Then what happens when I actually edit something? Well, at first when I'm in edit mode, so when I see the keyboard to type something, I first teleport all the chickens from one of those chambers into this red chamber. When I edit, then it happens inside here. The green parts are just the stored text, so to speak. Now when I press a key on my keyboard to change a letter at some point, it will activate one of those command blocks on top, each one representing a different character. And what they do is they summon in a chicken with the correct name inside this chamber and activate this line of command blocks down here, which will replace the original chicken at that position with the newly summoned one. That way I can replace different characters in my text. If I want to delete the last character, So I use the backspace, delete command, I activate this row of command blocks. That will just move the cursor one back and place a white space in there. Then to generally just move the cursor, I have these three command blocks. With that I can move left or right, depending on how many I activate. And then what's left is these command blocks here, the blue cells, and this clock setup. These three are responsible for giving us the cursor animation, this blinking line that tells us where we currently edit in the text. And the actual moving of the chickens to the edit chamber and back is done by these command blocks here, and also by these on the back. So yeah, that's a quick rundown. World download is of course in the description below. Thanks for watching. See you next time.